there are long-term effects from COVID of even some people who get mild disease have this strange long COVID disease that we don't quite understand, that could be prolonged fatigue and various catalog of symptoms. And I think that's going to be something for the future. And it would be another reason for, even if you're fit and healthy and you feel pretty good, you should get vaccinated just in case you become one of these individuals.
Yeah,
but I don't know. There's no long-term consequences of the vaccine that that have shown up in the clinical trials, right, Stu?
Yeah, that's correct. But again, it's been not really long-term.
Yeah.
I think the evidence that long-term effects occur from other vaccines is negligible. And so I don't expect that this would be the case. And I would reemphasize what Dr. McSorley's saying, which is basically the disease is bad. The vaccine is not bad, right? You may get transient side effects, but you're not going to be sick 10 months from now or 12 months from now like you are more likely to be if you actually get COVID-19, right? The risk benefit is so highly in favor of the benefit of the vaccine that I would not really be concerned about that.
Yeah, I mean, I understand people being cautious about anything these days, but I think vaccines have to be seen in the light of our history. You know, like if you think of smallpox, 300 million people died of smallpox in the 20th century, and it was eradicated in the 1970s because of vaccination. We used to, if you talk to your grandparents, they'll tell you about people with polio. They'll tell you about measles was rampant throughout our community in the 1950s and 60s, and vaccines have taken that out. So vaccines are a way to, it's not, the cost-benefit analysis is not, it's not like a, it's so far in favor of vaccination that it is, it's, I understand people's concern, but everyone should get vaccinated.